In this presentation, we are going to speak again about controllers, the part 5. So, the presentation layout is the following. I'm going to begin by explaining how a PID controller can be implemented digitally. Then I'm going to speak in part 2 about the absolute oppositional algorithm. In part 3, I'm going to speak about the incremental or velocity algorithm, and then in part 4, I'm going to present an example. So, currently, the great majority of industrial controllers are implemented using digital devices. So, if you are using a digital device, it is mandatory that we have a way to translate digital signals to analog signals and to sample analog signals to digital signals. So once we collect the data from the sensor, for instance, which has an analog signal, we have to convert it to a digital signal, and the we obtain a series of samples which are usually equally sampled in the time domain, where t is the sampling time. So the question is, how can we translate a digital equation for a PID controller in the parallel form, which is this one, to the digital domain? And to do this, we have to use an approximation for the integral part of the error and the derivative part of the error. So in the integral part, we can approximate the integral part using a sum of the product between the error in a given I sample multiplied by t, which is the sampling time. Regarding the derivative part, is simple. We can use an interpolation from the error in the sample k minus the error in the sample k minus 1 divided by the sampling time. So, where does come this approximation, this integral approximation? It comes for, so we need to approximate each of these sections, the area of these sections, using an approximation. And you begin by evaluating the area in this first area, and then we recursively evaluate the next one, and update the sum, so we can obtain the integral of the error in the recursive way. So the approximation that we are going to use here is known as the backward approximation, backward rectangular approximation, because we start from a sample n, and we use the rectangle backwards to the sample n minus 1. So the area is approximated, the area of this rectangle is approximated by multiplying the base, the sampling time, times the value of the sample, En. And this is the approximation which is used in this this sum here. So if you then replace this integral, the continuous integral, by the approximation, the sum, and the continuous derivative by this interpolation, we obtain a digital implementation, a digital of the PID controller, in the which is called the absolute form. This is the absolute oppositional form, and so we got the error in the sample k, they are a signal evaluated like this, and then it is common to represent this difference, the first regressive error difference, using this delta e, and then the integral of the error can be represented by using this variable z, which is obtained by the integral in the sample, the previous sample, plus the approximation of the rectangular approximation t times the error in sample k. So another way of representing the absolute form is this way, expressed by this equation. And so this is the expression that I'm going to use to present a simple algorithm to implement or simulate the PID controller in absolute form. I'm not going to explain in detail this algorithm, but that you can test or implement easily. So I use a variable t for the time, vk for the set point, ek for the error in sample k, ek minus 1 error in the sample k minus 1, zk is the integral, and zk minus 1 is the integral in the previous sample. Using a sampling time of 0.1 second, and this constant for the PID controller, kp, ti, and td, a simulation time of 10 seconds, the cycle is this one. Until the time is smaller than simulation time, the first thing is to evaluate the error, then update the integral of the error, zk, from the previous value, plus this approximation, then the equation of the uk, this is the absolute form, pass this value for the actuator and collect the value for the sensor. So this is a DAAD process. Update or store the value of AK and ZK, update the time, and that's it. Okay? You can try this in MATLAB and to see and adapt using a simulation model. Concerning the incremental or velocity algorithm, in this case we use the PID controller for in the sample k, and we consider the PID the output in sample k minus 1, and subtracting this to uk minus uk minus 1, we obtain this expression here. And as we can see, we have the first difference of the error here, ek minus zk minus 1. The sum of the error disappears, and it becomes just this part, which is very nice and has some benefits. And we get a term here, which is called the second regressive term of the error. So the algorithm for the velocity is more or less the same as before. What changes is that now we got the difference of the error and the second error difference, and of course instead of evaluating the absolute value, we evaluate the delta u, and then we just become this delta u and update the previous value of the controller. This implementation has an advantage, because as we don't have the sum of the integral, this implementation is less sensitive to windup, integral windup. So as an example, we are going to simulate a digital simulation for this model with the three poles using the absolute form of a PID controller. The first thing that you have to do is to convert this to the digital domain. We can do this using the Z transformer, and in MATLAB it's very easy, it's just to use this continuous two digital function model, and where this is numerator, denominator, sampling time, and it uses a zero order of old. And from that, we can convert the model from the Z transform for a different equation, for a difference equation model, which is represented here. So the parameters of the model are here, are these ones, and the gains that we are going to use for the controller are these ones, so PID, and this is the result for a step response when applied to the reference input in instant 0 in blue, and the output of the PID controller, as you can see. It is interesting to compare this implementation with the velocity or incremental implementation to see what are the differences, because there are always some difference depending on the approximation, and also compare with other implementations present in MATLAB and Simulink. So with this I conclude the presentation. All of this information can be found in the digital control books and PID books, and also some of it can be checked and verified in PID Control Simplified, the lecture notes for the classes. Thank you for your attention.